Hi, I'm Tom Coffin, CEO and president and co-founder of Simply Reliable Incorporated. Welcome to the SmartPRENEUR podcast. What's a SmartPRENEUR, you might ask? Well, a SmartPRENEUR, in our opinion, is someone that focuses on working on their business, not just in their business. And our SmartPRENEUR podcasts are designed to bring you some relevant information each week about your business and different parts of that business. It could be marketing, it could be workflow, it could be labor, it could be business operations, many things that we'll talk about each week on the podcast. You can also check out our SmartPRENEUR blog at simplyreliable.com. And of course, our SmartPRENEUR podcast is brought to you by Simply Reliable, makers of Smart Office and Design Machine, the complete end-to-end solution for business process for systems integrators. So thanks for joining us today, and I hope you enjoy the show. This week on the SmartPRENEUR podcast, our guest is Mark Cichowski. Mark is the CEO of Clarity AV International. Please welcome Mark Cichowski. Hi, Mark. How are you today?
I'm good, Tom. How about you?
Absolutely. Thanks for joining us again for the SmartPRENEUR podcast.
Yeah, it's great to be here. Great shows, and I'm looking forward to this next segment here.
Awesome. So today we're going to talk about one of the SmartPRENEUR blogs that Mark has written for us, and it's called Sales Foundations Part One. And in this week's SmartPRENEUR blog, you write about some specific characteristics that salespeople need to have. And one that really resonated with me was just being human. I thought that was kind of a really cool thing to talk about. Would you mind expounding about that, go a little deeper and maybe provide some examples of what you mean by that?
Absolutely. Being human is really just that. It's interacting in a way that almost like we're talking here. It's conversational. It's not scripted. It's not trying to get what you want. I mean, in our last blog, we talked about kind of a win-win scenario, right? And in a great sales relationship or relationship with a client, that being sincere, being treated how you want to be treated, not as, it's not somebody that's selling me something or I'm having somebody that's buying from me. It's somebody that I want to do business with. And those tend to lead to relationships to where you're getting referrals, you're getting additional business from that customer. There's a trust factor, and usually it's a much smoother scenario. And I think the customer is more accepting of what you are offering because they have that trust that you're going to do right by them. So that being human part really speaks to your character and you being, sincere in what you're trying to accomplish, which is getting that customer what they want and need. And of course, they're going to help you get what you want and need, which is a sale.
Yeah, boy, it just makes all the difference when you're talking to a good salesperson who is comfortable in their own skin.
Yeah.
And they treat you like a human being and they expect to be treated like a human being themselves as well.
Absolutely. Absolutely. The other thing, and this is something that, like a term that I use with people when I'm doing, education or sales or training, try to get the mentality of flipping your chair around. What I mean by that is, what is that other person's perspective? What are they looking to accomplish? What is their body language? What are they really looking for? And look at it from their perspective, not just you wanting to sell, but them wanting to get what they need from you. And look at it from their chair as opposed to yours. And I think you'll get more insight to get a successful transaction.
Absolutely. I remember one of the sales classes that really resonated with me was, don't sell them something, help them buy something.
Yeah, that's a great one. Really great. Yep.
Yeah. Another phrase that comes out of this week's blog that my kids heard this from me all the time was two ears and one mouth. Yeah. My kids just heard that thousands of times growing up throughout their life. And you state how important listening is, to the sales process.
Yeah.
Would you take us through on that one and give us a deeper dive into the mind of Mark Cichowski. Kachowski, sorry.
Right.
Cichowski.
I get that. I'm having a hard time. It's not like it's Smith,
But take us in the deep dark mind there, and talk us a little bit more, about listening skills.
Absolutely, this is a massive one. The people listening, if you're going to pay attention, this is the time, because that two ears, one mouth is actually very true. No matter if it's their kids or somebody that's well into their career, because so many people, there's a saying: seek to understand, not just to hear. Because people sometimes almost they wait their turn to talk as opposed to really listening to the person and then responding based on what that is. And then maybe say what you want to say, but listen to the other person first. And that listening technique to see what they're really looking for, that uncovers so much in a sales transaction that I think people discount it, meaning that they're so focused on, I need to talk about this. Or they get so techie. People ask them what time it is and they build them a watch. No, listen to what they're looking for. And listen to what their buying signals are and needs are, and that'll lead you towards a successful transaction. And I don't want to say it leads you towards a sale. What I mean by a successful transaction is a sale that sticks and leads to more and a better relationship. And that listening skill, Tom, that leads into another massive, important focus that I want people to listen to is qualifying. That's really what you're doing. When you're asking good questions, you're qualifying the consumer of what they're looking for, why they're looking for it. And then you get into things that you don't even have to ask, because you don't want to start the sale off by, oh, so much, how much you have to spend? And that's not the way you start a sale. What are you looking for? What are you looking to accomplish? Did you know about this? You're asking all these questions and you're qualifying the customer. And I'm not sure if I've coined this, but I call it funnel selling. If you start up here in a funnel and you start asking questions and questions, that you're getting smaller and smaller and smaller. And when it pops out, you should have a lot of information to get the customer to something that, frankly, they asked for based on your questions.
Makes sense. Makes a lot of sense. So speaking of questions, that leads into my next question, which is, Mark, should I ask yes or no questions? Now, I'm being a bit cheeky, but, would you discuss a bit about, about the problem with yes and no questions and really give some examples of what you mean when you talk about open-ended questions and why that's important in the sales process.
Yeah. Open-ended questions is a massive, again, it goes along with the listening and the qualifying we were just talking about a minute ago. But asking the right kind of questions also will help you, again, discover what the customer really needs and lead to a sale. So yes or no questions are pretty simple, and you don't want to really do too much. Would you like this or not? Well, no. Oh, then where do you go from there? But that's not the way you would want its conversation to go, as opposed to an open-ended question, which are answers that can't be answered with a yes or a no. So what are you looking for when it comes to technology or home? What have you seen out there that you might like? What have your friends and family told you about XYZ? You're asking questions to get the customer to talk. And I guess when you look at open-ended questions, think about that. What is going to elicit a conversational response from your customer, not just a simple yes or no answer? Because again, just like you're listening and qualifying, we were just talking about, you are allowing the customer to give you information based on what their needs are. And then you guide them down the path according to what they might need, what they might think they need, and then maybe what they really don't need, even though they thought they did. But again, if you don't ask those questions, you won't know, because it's yes, no, well, I like this, I don't like that. Do you like, it's like an alternative close. You want this one or this one? No, that's a closing technique. And so you're hoping they're going to choose one or the other. What if they say neither one? Then what do you say, right? So open-ended questions, you're getting the customer to talk.
Yeah, that's terrific. Well, smartpreneurs, I hope you enjoyed this podcast, our smartpreneur podcast, as much as I did with Mark. Talking about sales always improves your sales just because you're starting to think about it. Right, Mark?
That's right. Things are top of mind. And regardless of where you are in your career, if you're listening to this segment here, anything you know about sales, when you get back into a scenario like this where you're listening to somebody else, reading a book, doing audio audibles or something like that, it brings it back top of mind. I mean, every time that, like when we started talking, Tom, and I was looking at some of my notes and writing some of these things out, it's not like I didn't know these things, but I really hadn't thought about that for a long time. And you're always selling. I don't care if you're in a true sales scenario or trying to convince your wife to go for dinner. That's a sales environment, whether you like it or not. So
that's right.
Bringing these things top of mind and using these techniques and really looking at it like an art is really key for your success.
Absolutely. Well, again, thanks for your time today, Mark.
My pleasure.
And thanks, folks, for checking us out on the SmartPRENEUR podcast. And you can find this and our other podcasts at simplyreliable.com. You can find it and view it on youtube.com/simplyreliable or any place that you watch or listen to podcasts. We'll be out there and you can just search for SmartPRENEUR podcast and you'll find us. Mark, it occurs to me that some of these folks might want to give you a ring or look you up on the web. What's the best way for them to find you?
Sure, happy to. My website is clarity-, like the minus sign, AV, like audiovideo.com. Or you just email me, mark@clarity-av.com.
Awesome. Again, thanks, Mark. And thank you, SmartPRENEURs. We'll see you next time. Great selling. And check us out and check out the other podcasts that are out there. SimpleReliable.com. Thank you so much.
Thanks.